Hi, friends. Just kind of got a little, I guess emotional is what you would call it. Yeah, you ever get like that? I do. Quite often, actually. But it's not sadness anymore. Or despair. Or bankruptcy and emotional, spiritual. You know what I mean? Like despair. Loneliness and despair. That's not where my crying comes for anymore. It used to many years ago. But you know where it came from just now? Gratitude. And it always comes from gratitude, and it has for about 25 years now. This freaking character right stinking here. His name was Terry Fox, and in 1981, he succumbed to cancer. You've all heard of Terry Fox, and if you have not heard about Terry Fox, then you're not from Canada. This sucker was from Port Coquitlam, Vancouver. He ran a long way, friends, in 1981. Look at the cars. Let me look at the cop cars. I'm looking at you over here so I can see what's going on as I do this, right? Right? Okay, good, because I could look over there and see you. Don't think I ain't looking either. You know what I mean? So look at that. Ontario plate on that cop car. So we're in Thunder Bay. We just rolled into Thunder Bay, friends. It's pretty cool. And we are at the Terry Fox Monument. And you're almost a little bit of a nutcase if you don't come here, if you're Canadian or anybody that like I say, I got a little bit emotional there because he considered himself an average man, not a hero. He was ordinary in everything, in his own mind, except determination. And that's the part that gets me for some reason right there, you see? Yeah, it does. Because you need determination, friends. In life, you do. Got me again, you see? Did, got me again. I'm a sappy guy. But you know, like this character, I'm gonna flip you around here, but I'll show you, like, I mean, this is an amazing time in history, and just, 1958 to 1981. He died in 81. Okay? He started his run, if I'm not mistaken, in 81 and died in 81. It's actually amazing. Okay? And here he is. What a freaking legend and an absolute sign of determination, as a matter of fact. To me, it just said it. He's ordinary. He said it himself. I'm ordinary in everything except determination. What an amazing man. And I don't know why that gets me a little bit kind of, you know, water in the eyes kind of thing. See old Morgan over here? Look at him. See? He's kind of reminiscent a bit too. Anybody in Canada that's, you know, been around this gig, this Terry Fox gig thing, it's crazy. Officially dedicated June 26, 1982 by Right Honorable Edward Richard Shire, Governor General of Canada, Honorable John Blackaird, Lieutenant Governor of Ontario, Premier of Ontario, Honorable James Snow, Minister of Transportation and Communications, Honorable Leo Bernier, Minister of Northern Affairs. So, pretty amazing moment, you know. Did you pick up any emotions around this thing? You did, didn't you? I did too. And so, what does this mean to you? Like, how do you put him or what he did into your what brings emotion for you? For me, it's his dedication. That's.
I was 16 when he did this, right?
So. Yeah. Yeah, and you're what? 57?
57, yeah.
So, you were what?
I was 16 years old.
Okay, so I was 11.
Yeah, so, I mean, It was huge.
This guy's running around with one leg.
Yeah.
Really, friends, it was massive. But, like, I'm a bit goofy.
Yeah, me too.
I'm almost a little
bit... You know,
bit...
It's interesting how you know, you can know about something like this all your life, and now it's fresh again.
I know.
Right?
I know. It's crazy. But I wonder why that is. Maybe because we're a little bit older and we've had some life.
This is quite a thing. This is where he ended his run, right?
Was it?
Yeah.
Right here.
Yeah.
In
this is where he had to
probably on this stretch of highway.
He had to call it quits right around here.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, he had to call her quits, eh? So I'm uploading this freaking stuff. I don't care. I don't care if people see me with water in my eyes. I don't care. I've done it before and I'll do it again. This channel is about real life and it just is. Thanks, Morgan, for sharing that. You know, I just don't care. I'm going to flip you around and I'm going to show you this. And I'm a Canadian. And I'm a proud, proud Canadian. And I'm going to show you this guy, okay? Let's have a look at him. I mean, think about this for a minute, friends. Think about what this young 22-year-old man did. He did enough to have a freaking this thing on the top of a mountaintop looking out over this right here. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Thunder Bay. It's absolutely amazing. How you guys doing?
Hey.
Pretty amazing.
Man.
I was almost getting a little emotional. That vision, you know, that scene is just, I don't know why that brings me emotion today. I've seen it 1,000 times, and I guess maybe because I'm here, I don't know. But that's enough sappiness out of me right now. But I think we can only use these things in our own lives as, I don't know, inspiration. It takes a lot for me to be inspired, friends. Honestly, I'm not easily inspired. I'm not easily impressed. I'm not easily inspired. I have extremely high expectations of myself. Extremely. About what I say. About how I act, about how I think, what I do, thought, deed, you know what I'm talking about? Energy, the sponsoring thought behind the action. What's behind what you're about to do? Are you doing that with an expectation attached to it? Are you buying that guy's coffee or buying that fella on the street his lunch because you think you might gain something from that? Or are you doing it from the goodness of your heart in compassion and just for the fact that you want to make that person better somehow and help them? What's it? So that's the sponsoring thought behind the act, behind the deed. So be careful how you give. Truly, I mean it. Ready? See you later.